Este grabo está. Vima bev and chepper watching a new music video on the computer. This way up is my favorite band ever. Said Vima, they're brilliant. What's all this noise? Asked Dad. It isn't noise, Dad, said Viv. It is the new song by This Way Up. Dad watched the video for a moment. Do you call that dancing? He said, this is dancing. Dad started to do a few dance moves of his own. Biff and Chip shook their heads. Please stop, said Chip. Dad just can't dance. After that, later that afternoon, Mom took the children shopping in town. There were loads of people waiting outside the concert hall. This way up is playing a concert here tonight, said Vima. Vima looked sad. My mom tried to buy tickets for us, but they were sold out, she said. They stopped and looked at a poster of the band. Which one do you like best? Asked Vima. They thought hard. Elfie's the best singer, but Teddy's the best dancer. She said, I like Teddy the best. Well, she was saying this, a man with sunglasses and a big bushy beard walked by. Vima turned around and stared at the man. Stared at the man with the beard. What is the matter, Vima? Asked Chip. That man looks very familiar, said Vima. Sunny, the man sneezed for just a moment. His beard seeped down. Vima gasped. That beard isn't real, she said, pointing. Excitedly. I know who that man is. He's Teddy from This Way Up. Shall we ask him for an autograph? Asked Biff. A couple of This Way Up fans overheard. Vima, did you hear what that girl just said? One fan shouted, it's Teddy. The man with the beard looked back over his shoulder. Then he started to hurry away. More fans had heard the news about Teddy and were rushing over. Teddy shouted to one fan, we love you. The man with the fake beard broke into a run. Teddy! Screamed one of the fans, come back. The eager fans pushed past the children and then they started to run after the man. I think we'd better get home, said Mom. As they got into the car, Vima and Biff chatted happily about spotting the singer. I just hope he's okay, said Jeff. All those fans were very excited. Before she drove off, Mom looked in the rear view mirror. Look behind you, children, she said. The children turned and saw someone running towards them. It was Teddy. The pop star looked worried. Please save him, get in. Teddy looked back nervously. You could see the fans running round the corner towards him. Then he jumped in the car and Mom drove off. Chip looked through the rear window. The fans were howling in the disappointment. Inside the car, Teddy was still out of breath from running Thank you, he panted. Emma couldn't believe that he was sitting right in front of her. What were you doing inside this guy's? She asked, Daddy grinned nervously. It is the only way I can go outside on my own without fans spotting me. Where can I drop you off? Asked Mom. There'll be fans outside the hotel, said Daddy. Is it okay if I come to your house? I can call our manager from there. Is it okay, Saber? Yes. At home, Teddy made a call to his manager. When he had finished, Dad was looking at him with a puzzled expression. You look familiar, he told Teddy. You were in the little shop on the corner, don't you? Said Teddy. He's a famous pop star, Dad said Biff. So maybe Flabby shouldn't be jumping all over him, said Chip. Get down, Flabby. Just then, the doorbell rang. That must be my manager, said Teddy. Biff began the door. Biff opened the door. A woman stressed a microphone toward the cell. Is it true that Daddy from this way up is in your house? She demanded. Behind the woman, there were lots of people with flashing cameras. Without answering, Biff shut the door quickly. That wasn't your manager, she told Daddy. There are lots of reporters outside. Mom meant to close the curtains at the front of the house. There are lots of fans arriving too, she said. Teddy looked worried again. I'm really sorry about this, he said. How am I ever going to get past that crowd? Vilma was grinning. I've got an idea, she said. Outside, the crowd in the street had grown bigger and bigger. More fans joined the photographer and reporters. Suddenly, a reporter shouted, look, someone's coming from the back of the house on a bike. The cyclist was wearing sunglasses and had a big bushy beard. That is the same disguise he was wearing before, shouted a fan. It is Teddy after him, shouted a photographer. The crowd began to start after the bike. The cyclist kept looking over his shoulder as he turned one corner and another. Then he stopped. He was in the dead end. Slowly, he got off his bike and turned to face the crowd. Take that silly disguise of Teddy and show us some dance moves, shouted a photographer. Okay then, said the cyclist, pulling the sunglasses and beard off. That's not Teddy, yelled the fan. That looks like someone's dad. Dad didn't know any dances moves by this way up, but he didn't want to disappoint the crowd. He decided to show them some of his own dance moves. Meanwhile, Mom and the children were driving off with Daddy in the car. I can hear booing, said Wilma. That probably means the crowd has caught up with Dad, said Chip with a grin. Mom and the children took Teddy to meet his manager. Thanks for everything, said the professor. I'd like all of you to come to the concert tonight. You can be my guests. That evening, the whole family was excited as they arrived for the concert. Lady was waiting for them in a room behind the stage. Come and meet the rest of the band, he said with a smile. When the concert started, the family watched from the side of the stage. Teddy spoke to the crowd. This song is for my friends Wilma, Beth, and Chip, he said. As the song started, the band did one of their new dance routines that watched every step and backflip very, very carefully. They are not too bad, I suppose, he said. The end.